this client called me, brand new customer. He wanted some maintenance done on his furnace, so I'm here doing a maintenance. This furnace is approximately 20 years old. It's a Comfortmaker. As you can hear, the draft inducer is really loud. He's supplying the draft inducer. He just moved in here. They actually had one here, so I'm going to replace the draft inducer. Before I do that, though, I'm going to do a combustion tune to make sure everything's good to go. So that way we're not spinning our wheels on replacing parts that eventually got to replace the furnace. So right off the gate, so far everything's looking good. I like to see the O2 drop. This furnace just fired up, so I'm going to let it run and get it full state heat ready before I make any kind of determinations. As you can see, it is starting to drop a little bit, so that's good. That's a good sign. So we'll let that run for a few minutes. So it just reached steady state. Yeah, numbers look good, so I think we can proceed with checking out the rest of the system. So, if your blower, if your draft inducer sounds like this, you need a new draft inducer, for sure. The bearings are going to seize up and you won't have no heat. So in this job, my customer, he just moved in the house. They actually had this sitting in the house, brand new, so I'm going to replace it for him. He already had the part, so... So let me set you up here, and I'll get busy in replacing this motor. So sometimes with these, this collector box will crack, just gets too hot. But this one looks like in good shape. So it's something you want to look at on these ICP models is you can see the cold coming in and it's making it. But yeah, usually these will crack, but this one looks good. I'm going to take this gasket off and then I'm going to put the new one on. Comes as a kit, so I'll replace that and probably run up and grab my vacuum too. Now I'm going to check the ohms for this Honeywell hot surface igniter. If you're reading that 4.6, we're good. Anywhere from 4 to 10 is good with these igniters. Thank you. that's what a new inducer sounds like. Definitely a lot quieter on that. So let's check for amp draw on the blower. First, let me check this capacitor. Oh, let me just pop that out of there. So this one is a, if you can read that, 7 UF, 7.5. So let's see what it reads. 6.38. So we're, this is weak. So let me go grab a capacitor. 7.69, we're good to go on that one. So that's made for a round. This is an oval. I'm just going to put tape on that and zip tie it to the wires. It will be just fine. Now, the reason of this capacitor, it's got some kind of chemical in it, and this is what starts the motor. You have to have this, and if it is really weak, the motor will basically grunt, and it won't start up, and it'll be a no heat or no cool situation. Now I'm going to test blower amps, and by doing that you put it around the lead for heat, and I'm going to check. I use my job link app on my phone. This filter's dirty. Let me check the draft inducer amps, being it's brand new. We're 2.2 amps, so we're good. 2.38 amps. So we're within specs on that. We are good. This furnace lives another day. Yep, when somebody asks me how my day is going, I always say I'm living the dream. Because I am. You know why? Do you know why I'm living the dream? That's me. I work for myself. That's me. And you can do that too. Work for yourself. Or work for a company. Doesn't matter. You got to start somewheres. So that's it, guys. Leave your thoughts and feedback in the comment section below. See you in the next one.